Hey everybody, welcome back to another Maple Peak board game video. Today we are going to be unboxing the new game, the Fox Experiment Kickstarter edition, fresh from Kickstarter. I just got it in the mail today. I've been looking forward to this game for quite some time, and I'm glad it finally got here. Here's, let's see. So I got the 1-4 player base game. I kind of regret not getting the 5-6 player, but meh, I don't do it that often anyway. But you're going to be breeding foxes for particular traits, and I'm not exactly sure. I've been trying to avoid what exactly the game is about, but I know, you know, I saw the base game on Kickstarter and it looked really cool. So 1-4 players, looks like 60 minutes, ages 14 and up. And let's just open it here. I got some promo cards. Pretty cool. I like promos. And this one is, like I said, is the Kickstarter edition, so it comes with a bunch of really cool upgraded premium fancy pants components that I'm looking forward to seeing, because normally the little foxes look like these wooden meeples here, but I get these fancy printed ones, the little foxes on them. Man, my copy got a little bash, but oh well, nothing horrible. Right off the bat, rule book. Let's pull that out, shove this aside. That's kind of cool. Startling enough, staring at me as I open the box. A list of components, not too shabby. You know, it's one of my favorite things. Main board, player boards. I think the player boards are supposed to be dual layered. I might be wrong. And yeah, see, this is, all these components are different now. This particular one, really nice, illustrations. Looks like the rules are fairly well laid out. Nice big rule book. Phase one, selection, breeding, research. And sorry if you hear my phone buzzing in the background. Oh, this is cool. It looks like a notebook. That's nice. I like that. I always like those little touches. Two-player mode. Solo. There you go, Bradley. Another solo game for you. Appendix. Turn summary. Nice. Okay, we'll see what else we got in the box. We'll keep that nearby. So it looks like a cool piece of artwork here. Here. This little fox. So yeah, there we go. The upgraded edition, standard, fancy foxes. We'll keep that aside just to make sure they did what they're supposed to do. We have some advertisements. Yay. Bunches and bunches of tokens. Bunches more. Ooh, and a nice insert. There we go. Cool. And my insert got a little munched too. What's this? What do we have? Yeah, this is the main board. It is not very big. And it is 1-3, 5-6, so I'll only ever use that side. For such a grandiose game. Oh, nice dice. The main board is not very big. Yeah, see, these are the nice... You can kind of see the swirls of silver in them. Very nice. Those are really nice dice. Cool. Well done, Panda. Bunches of dice. Some cards. Look at those in a second. Here's some foxes. Some old foxes. So these are the ones you're going to be bidding on, like the mother and the father. And then they'll be having puppies, which you get to name. And you'll mark certain traits on those dogs, I believe. Some markers. Cool. Hoping to get this to the table this weekend. Oh, nice. Some big metal gears. Those are bigger than I thought they would be. Wow. Those are thick. Those are nice. Those are much nicer than cardboard ones. And here we have some of the foxes. There's tokens, and more tokens in this game. It's awesome. And they are all acrylic. That is really nice. And I like that the foxes are actually all different colors. There's like a black, there's a light brown gray, there's a white one, and then there's flat out red. Here. Let's see. Let me grab one of each and green screen it. Just make a big mess here. And light blue. Okay. Green screen! Yeah, so there we're gonna move them up a bit. Yeah, those are really nice. I mean, each one of them looks different. You know, there's a few of these that are repeats. But they're front and back, which is really nice. Those are super nice. These are a lot nicer than the Jeeples that they had in Dinosaur World. They've definitely improved on that design. And assuming these are marking first, second, third, fourth players. Very cool. Assuming these mark a particular type of trait, but I'm not sure what it is. I will find out. Actually, no, these aren't. I think these are like a wild token that you can use as any particular trait. And then these are the traits. There's three of them. That one's hard to tell what the heck the cross, the goo in it. But this is like a big fluffy tail. And then this other one is barking. So you have that, and that. Oh, there's one more. Ears. Looks like the type of ears. Ears, something or other, tails. Yeah, where'd the barky one go? Here. Green screen! Yeah, so there you go. There's the four type. They're really nice. Those are nice tokens.
It's well produced. I'm glad I went for the Kickstarter copy.
There wasn't much price difference in the two, so I didn't see any reason not to. Plus, really, it's fun. It's very nice. And then stars of some sort. Let's see. Component list. Yep, so those are the traits. There's the friendly token, round markers, dogs, bonus points, player markers, and fancy dice. Okay, let's shove some of that out of the way. And let's look at some cards. Then we're gonna mess with the little thing. Try and open them. Open. Dang it. Nice and tight. Come on, come on. Good grief. There we go. I think these are for like solo and two player. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. Anyway, let's look. Here's some of the pups. So it looks like there's one for each color, player color. And then you have the Mao and the Pao dogs. So the male and the females. All the females. The males, and they're all named already. They have certain dice that come with them, so that must be part of some sort of bidding process to be able to get those guys. Oh, quick player quick reference cards. Nice. Here, let's see. Get a little closer look. So there's one of the pups. The Ma and the Pa, mother and the father. You can see on this one, it has the place for the dry erase markers where you can mark what traits they have. And then these particular dogs give you the dice that you need. The cards are really nice. You can definitely tell a difference between the ones that are made for dry erase and the ones that aren't. And then it looks like scientists, military. I have no idea. Okay, so there's an A and a B side. Ooh, she's kind of creepy looking. One, two, three, four, five, six. Well, that's cool. Okay, that's nice. Let's see. Some books. Wonder if that's for the solo. Let's take a quick look and see what we can see. So these are study cards. And then, yeah, these are AI selection cards. 30 science cards, which look like they might be some sort of bonus. After rolling all pups, keep one of your pups as a parent for the next generation. It cannot earn friendliest. I can read. Okay. So maybe some special player powers you can pick up as you go. Look like they have some victory points in the corner. let you roll some extra dice. There's a whole stack of those. That's pretty cool. Yeah, so there you go. There's everything in Fox Experiment. It looks like it's going to be a fun game. I really am happy about the upgrade of components. It's well produced. It's gotten, this game has gotten some really good ratings. I was wrong, though, however. We'll go back to this for 2 seconds. I thought these were dual-layered, but they are not dual-layered player boards. Which, I'm sad, but meh, whatever. And then all these tokens, which are replaced. Except for these, maybe. Pop out some tokens. Maybe they'll go to the convention in March, maybe they won't. Which, shout out to everybody. Thank you for backing the Kickstarter. It is 100% funded. It's got a couple of days left to go. But it's on. We got a convention again in March. Okay, well, please like and subscribe if you'd like to see more of these videos. That's the best way of letting me know. Leave me any comments or questions down in the comments section. I'd like to hear from everybody. And that's it for now. I'll talk to you later. Thanks. Bye.